Choosing the wrong Python framework for your web app can be a costly mistake. So I set out to find which one is the fastest Python web framework, which among Flask, Django, and FastAPI can handle the most requests. And I'll also share when you should use each framework. I compared three types of endpoints. The first is a basic ping endpoint, which simply replies with a pong message. It checks how fast the framework handles a simple request. This code is in FastAPI, and I also created similar code for Flask and Django. I deployed these simple applications on AWS C5.large EC2 instances, just like I did in my previous video, where I find out the best way to deploy a FastAPI application. After deployment, I sent multiple requests, more specifically 300 concurrent requests, continuously for 30 seconds. And as you can see, Flask and FastAPI handled almost the same number of requests per second, around 4,500 RPS, while Django in whiskey mode handled around 4,000. Django ESGI was way too slow at around 1,600 RPS. These Python web frameworks handle synchronous and asynchronous endpoint differently. So I defined the endpoint functions with the async def instead of def. The RPS of FastAPI increased significantly to 6,252. RPS of Django in ESGI mode also increased but was still the lowest, and RPS of Flask dropped by more than half to around 2000. The second type of endpoint I tested was a CPU bound endpoint. Here I basically summed up all the numbers between 1 and 1 million. As you can see, Flask was the fastest, handling a little more than 24 requests per second, followed by Django Whiskey. FastAPI and Django ESGI were at around 20 RPS. When I converted the endpoints to async def, the performance of FastAPI and Django ESGI improved to just under 24 RPS, which is comparable with Flask. The third and final type of endpoint I tested was an I/O bound endpoint. These are operations like reading or writing to disk or performing a network operation like a database query. Basically, during these operations, the CPU is idle, waiting for the operation to complete. In my endpoints, I used the time.sleep method to simulate this by sleeping for 100 milliseconds in each request. For these endpoints, FastAPI was the fastest, handling around 1550 requests per second, followed by Django ESGI at around 1380 RPS. The reason is that these two frameworks handle each request in a separate thread when using normal Python functions. However, Flask and Django in whiskey mode handle the request sequentially. If I change the endpoint function to async def and use async io.sleep instead of time.sleep, the performance of both FastAPI and Django in ESGI mode improved even further. That's because there's no thread overhead when running asynchronous endpoints. The performance of Flask and Django in whiskey mode remained the same. Now let me answer the question I ran all these tests for. Which Python web framework is the fastest, and when should you use each one? In most cases, FastAPI is the fastest except for heavy computation endpoints, where Flask is a little bit faster than FastAPI and Django. To answer the second question, if your backend application has endpoints that are purely computational, no database queries or disk or network operations involved, you can use bare-bone Flask, but the advantage is not very significant, so you could also go with Django or FastAPI if you want to use their out-of-the-box features like input validation, the Django admin site, or FastAPI Swagger documentation. For I/O bound operations, FastAPI is a very clear winner, but Django has its own advantage, like its powerful admin interface. These are the commands I use to deploy each application, and you can check out the code repository using the link in the description. Subscribe.